Hey everyone, in the last video, I was looking at some noise that I was seeing in my walkie talkie project.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
It's a weird one, as normally I'd associate this kind of noise with noise on the power supply when sending Wi-Fi data. We've seen this before with analog microphones and their very sensitive preamps, but I've never seen it with I2S MEMS microphones, which have always seemed to be much more robust. I'd also checked the 3.3 volt line with my oscilloscope during Wi-Fi transmission, and I couldn't see any noise. One of the viewers suggested that it could be physical noise from vibrating components, and for a while I didn't believe this could be the case, as I could actually hear some noise that seemed to coincide with the Wi-Fi transmission, and I even managed to capture some of this noise with my desktop microphone. However, the majority of people were pretty convinced that it must be power line noise, so I thought I'd better double check. Previously, to fix this kind of issue, I've taken a feed off the 5-volt supply, passed it through an LC filter, and followed that by an LDO regulator. This gives you a really nice clean signal for the microphone. So I wired this up on some breadboard, and here's the result.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
The noise has gone. Problem solved, you may think. But I thought I would double check and wired up the microphone directly to the 3.3 volt line.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
There's a bit of noise, but nowhere near the amount we see on the walkie-talkie. After a bit of head-scratching, the only real difference between my test circuit and the walkie-talkie circuit is that I'm using a different ground pin on my walkie-talkie circuit. This is what happened when I changed the ground pin.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
The noise is still there, but it's considerably reduced. What's really interesting is if I use the same ground pin in my test circuit, I still don't see any noise. So this is really board specific and quite strange. But the quality is probably good enough for my use case. I am going to make up some PCBs though with the power filter so that we get the best quality. I'll do a new video once the PCBs arrive and we can test them together. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.